Hi, welcome to our YouTube channel. If you didn't subscribe our YouTube channel yet, please do it now. It would be useful for us. If you already did, thank you so much for that. Today we will review another Caveco fountain pen. As you already know, I'm a collector of Caveco sports, but today this one is longer, as you can see. So let's check. This is the Caveco Dia with the chrome finish. Let's see how the pen looks like. So first of all, it comes inside this box that is inside a cardboard sleeve, a black one with Caveco logos, and you're used to this, I believe. When we take this out, you will see not the usual tin box, but this one with this leather finish. It has a closure there, and you open, you have the Caveco logo there, and here you have the pen. This is the Caveco Dia 2, as I told you. What are the details about this pen? First of all, this is a bigger pen than the Caveco Sport, and it has a very classic look. It has these knurled parts on the top of the cap, on the bottom of the barrel, as they used to be on the older models. It has a double cap ring here at the bottom of the cap, a cap ring that is a part of the clip with this retro style here on the top of the cap, and another one on the bottom of the barrel. It also has the name of the model, Caveco Dia Germany, and you have the typical Caveco logo, this medallion, on the top of the cap, but here also on the bottom of the barrel. So the pen is like this. Let's just see how it compares with the Caveco Sport. And as you can see, it is much bigger pen. When you compare this pen with the Lamy Safari, you'll see it is big, but not that big. It's not a big pen, it's just bigger than the Caveco Sport. The pen we think is more similar to this one is this. This is the Parker Dufold international size, not the big one. And as you can see, it is very similar. It also has this ring, the double ring here, and then another one there. The size is the same, so they are very similar pens. So, about this one, this is made of acrylic, it's not ABS plastic. It has all the metal fittings are chrome colored, and it is quite nice. It has a nice weight, and it has a decent size. Not a big pen, but with a decent size. The cap unscrews, and here we have the section with the same format of the sport section, and we have the nib. Inside, it will take along the international cartridges or too short or a converter. This pen also has inside, and I think you'll be able to see this, a spring. When I do this, it will come off. Just to make sure that if you use only one short cartridge, if you hit the pen, the cartridge doesn't dislodge from here and is rattling around. So there's no mess, no noise inside. Quite nice. The acrylic is very nice, very well finished, very shiny. And this pen, in my opinion, has only one problem. And it's not a problem. It's something that I don't like, and that's just one thing, is the Nib. Why? I love the Nib. I also love, already love the Nib of Lilliput, of Caveco Sport, and so on. But the problem with this Nib is that it has the same size of the Nib of a Caveco Sport. And it would be acceptable if the pen wasn't bigger. So when you look at it, this nib looks too short for the section. Too short and too narrow for the section. I really would love to have a bigger nib. I believe the size for the Caveco Sport, the nib size, is alright. On the Lilliput, it is the same nib and it looks a big nib because Lilliput is so small, but for this one, it looks too small, in my opinion. So, if this pen had a bigger nib, it would be great. And when I look at this pen, and because it reminds me of a Parker International Lufold, I just imagine, and if Caveco made a pen exactly like this one, but with a bigger nib and bigger size, and similar to a Parker Centennial Lufold, it would be great, in my opinion. This pen is more expensive than a regular Caveco Sport, and is around 100 euros. But it is a very nice and beautiful pen. It looks classy. It looks expensive. It looks really, really nice. Let's see now how this pen writes. This pen has been unkept for a while I was talking, so let's see if it writes right away. About the length of the pen, as you can see, it is quite comfortable to hold. It is long enough. If you want, it posts and posts really securely, so you can write with the cap posted. It won't get too top heavy, but I just don't like it. I prefer to hold the cap in my hand. So let's see how the pen writes and the paper it wrote right away is the Rhodia dot pad. The pen is the Caveco Dia 2 with chrome trim with an F nib, and the nib is made of steel. I didn't mention it, but it is made of steel. But because the nib has a unit that can be unscrewed easily, you can buy any other Caveco Sport nib that is available, and you can change for a different size, a different grade nib, like an EF, B, or an M, or a double B, or whatever you want. You can ch change this for a gold colored nib, a black colored nib, or even to a gold nib. So you can have a lot of options, but I think this is the one that really makes sense with the pen. So this is Caveco Dia 2 Chrome, and the ink is this time the Visconti Brown. So, about the pen, there is no surprise about it because it writes as well as a sport. This one is quite wet, more than many sports I have, but the nib performs perfectly. And you can write fast, and there is no problem of skipping. Only when you change the angle like this to something that is not correct, but the pen is really, really good. You can try to write upside down, but it doesn't. And you can try to have some line variation, and it is possible to have some, but you have to force it very hard, and it's not advisable to do if you don't want to ruin your pen. So, this is a really nice pen. And as you can see, it writes very, very well. It's a very smooth nib. I find Kaveh Konibs to be very good. I read lots of problem about Kaveh Konibs, but usually they are with broad and double broad nibs, and they refer to baby bottom problems. With the F and the M nibs that I prefer, I never had any problem, and I have a lot of Kaveh Konibs. So, just to finish the video, I have to say that this pen was sent to us by Caveco. I really liked it. So thank you, Caveco, for sending the pen. Thank you all for watching the video. If you like this one, please hit the thumbs up button. And if you want to add something or to ask any question, leave it on the comment section below. And if you really like this and if you want to see more of our videos, please subscribe our YouTube channel. Once again, thank you so much for being here, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.